preparation so far?
Well, first, because this happened when I was out of the country, and I'm the chairperson of Roads Transport and Infrastructure in Senate. The operations of Kenya Ferry Services indeed fall under the docket of my committee, which I chair. And I must first condole with family and Kenyans at large, and say unequivocally that those bodies must be recovered.
Mm-hmm.
They have to be. We don't have another choice.
Mm-hmm.
And secondly, really to say that we have not done what we should have done, what Kenyans expect us to have done
mm-hmm.
in the face of such a disaster, given the fact that we have the lessons that we ought to have learned since Mutongwe.
Mm-hmm.
Let it also be known that the services that are offered by Kenya Ferry Services at that channel are not free entirely. Kenyans pay. I mean, a vehicle to cross from one side to the other side, they pay. There is revenue generated. Indeed,
mm-hmm.
I remember we looked at that question of about how much do these people raise. They raise a lot of money for that matter. And so it's not that they would argue they're starved of resources to implement procedures, and especially security procedures. I've heard, and I'm sure everybody has heard and followed this case, and all the questions that are lingering on Kenyans' minds. You know, why wasn't there timely action? You know, why wasn't there proper coordination for all these years?
Mm-hmm.
Why hasn't there been a pre-arranged or meditated way of response in the event of such a disaster?
Public policy failure, perhaps?
Probably. And if you look at, for example, some of the issues being raised by Kenyans right now,
yes.
and especially on in the media, and I would say social media,
mm-hmm.
That is not only one incident that caught Kenyans' eyes. There have been other incidents.
Mm-hmm.
I was amazed the other day when I was traveling, and then I went there when I arrived to Mombasa to find out. And a Kenyan there was saying that there is a guy there who makes a living out of diving down into the deep to go and retrieve spare parts and sell.
Wow.
I mean, of vehicles which have
drowned
in there.
Mm-hmm.
And he was saying that he's demanding a fee of $2 million to go down and work on that body.
Mm.
And then probably, lastly,
mm-hmm.
I would say, you know, Kenya Ferry Services were preparing, and they have advertised that they are about to launch and implement a cable car operation there at that channel. And then what one would want to be asking is, if they want to fly Kenyans over that channel on cable cars, and you
look
know,
at the infrastructure itself, and they
cannot
the
deal with the ferries, and they have been dealing with ferries for all this time, I think we need a better job, and we'll be sitting down with them. We've invited them to our committee, including the people that are concerned.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm glad now that the military is in there. They should have done that a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
That's my thinking.
Right.
And you know, let me just finalize by saying this. Really, part of what has been making Kenyans unhappy about this is, if you look at the proximity of, for example, the Navy, from where that incident was occurring. So, you know, all those coincidences are not pleasant to Kenyans. We cannot afford to be another Malaysia that declared that their plane carrying hundreds of people has just vanished into the air, and nobody knows where those people are. We must bring closure to this, and I think also organize ourselves to do better and prepare ourselves.
And we'll come.